Good morning, friends, and welcome to Soul Fuel. For our brief meditation this morning, let's turn our Bible to the book of Prophet Nahum, chapter 1, verse 7. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble. He knows those who take refuge in Him. To stand on mountains, He raised me up is a book written by Helen Grace Lashid. This book holds a collection of stories about people who have struggled and overcome their mountains, such as life's distressing iniquities, trials, and disappointments. They are ordinary people of different ages who have confessed to weaknesses and failures. They get discouraged, and at times they succumb to temptation and make wrong choices. But through it all, they have come to know the one who raises up the weak and puts their feet on solid rock. They have learned to turn obstacles into opportunities of growth, difficulties into daring faith, and challenges into creative caring. In this book, she writes, "Our circumstances are not an accurate reflection of God's goodness. Whether life is good or bad, God's goodness, rooted in His character, is the same." In Nahum chapter 1 verse 7, we find a beautiful expression of God's love in the midst of an oracle of judgment. In this one little verse, we find a theology of hope and a profound argument as to why we should not despair in the midst of difficult times. Nahum begins by making a statement about the goodness of God. The Lord is good. The goodness of God is fundamental and foundational theology. Now, there can be no true relationship if you fear that the one with whom you are in relationship wishes you ill. But this is not so with God. He is good and is kindly disposed to lost humanity. For this reason, He offers us His mercy, His forgiveness, and His sheltering protection. To reject this is to invite the wrath of God and to push away all of the good He intends for us. But let us make no mistake, our great God is good. Not only is God good, Nahum says He is able. He is able to protect us. Nahum says the Lord is a stronghold in the day of trouble. Now, this was the word that God's children needed to hear. After years of oppression at the hands of Assyria, they needed to know that God could indeed right these wrongs and protect His people. Nahum responded with a resounding yes. God, he prophesied, a stronghold in the day of trouble. This was a popular image in the book of Psalms 2. There are many verses which say so. Psalm 9 verse 9, "The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble." Psalm 18 verse 2, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold." Psalm 27 verse 1, "The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid?" The image of God as a God of protection and safety has ever comforted His children throughout difficult times. This word and this image is needed by us today, as it was needed by Judah in the days when Nahum spoke it. The pandemic situation has hurt many. It has frightened many. It has wounded many, and many are trembling because of the uncertainty the pandemic has brought about. This is where we need to trust and believe that God is able to save, that God is a fortress, that God, as Nahum put it, is a stronghold in the day of trouble. And He is. He is. Nestled here in the middle of a terrifying declaration of God's wrath is a beautiful expression of God's protective love. God's love is the ultimate foundation for our theology of God. Here Nahum says in the last part of this verse, "The Lord knows those who take refuge in Him." What a great assurance! He knows us. We need to understand that God loves us with deliberate and exhaustive intent. His love is strong. His love is secure. His love seeks our good to His glory. In John chapter 10 verse 14, Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep." Here is Jesus' articulation of Nahum's great truth. The Lord knows those who take refuge in Him. Jesus says, "I know my own and my own know me." My dear friends, we are known and we are purchased. And great was the price that was paid. Dear friends, can you trust in God? Can you know that He is with you? I would say, yes, we can. Nahum has said it beautifully. Nahum was pointing to Jesus without even knowing it at that time. For Jesus is the ultimate expression of the goodness of God, of the ability of God, and of the love of God. Our God is good. Our God is able. Our God is love. Heavenly Father, You are God alone. There is no other who can do more than I can ever dream of. You are able, and we thank You for Your goodness and love. Amen. God bless you.